Hello everyone! In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this sketch effect in Photoshop. With the power of smart objects, you will learn how to create your own PSD file that can be used to reapply the sketch effect on any image with a couple of clicks. Please like the video and let's get started. Step 1. Create the sketch effect. First, let's create a new document. Change width to 3000 pixels and height to 2500 pixels. Keep resolution 300 with 8-bit RGB color mode. Then click Create. Now let's import our image. From Place Embedded, choose your image, then click Place. Extend your image to fill the canvas like this. Position it as you want, then press Enter. Now press Ctrl and A to select the whole canvas. Then with your layer selected, press Ctrl and J. This will take a duplicated version of your image with the same dimensions of the canvas. Now right-click the layer and choose Convert to Smart Object. Delete the main layer and also the background layer using the Delete key. And with your layer selected, press Ctrl and J to duplicate it. Hide the bottom layer and double-click the top one to open its layer style. After opening the layer style menu, click on the blending options. And there you can find the Blend If property. Go to this layer slider. And by moving this slider, I'm telling Photoshop to hide every pixel that is brighter than the slider value. For example, every pixel that is brighter than this value will be transparent like that. Now move the slider to 30. And let's zoom in and see the result. As you can see, the remaining pixels will be sharp like that. To smooth the result, hold the Alt key and click and drag the slider to split it. Move the second part of the slider to 160. Click OK, and let's apply a pattern overlay. If I add the pattern to the same layer, I will get something like that. The pattern will take priority from the Blend If, and it will be applied to the whole image. And to fix that, I'll need to select the layer and press Ctrl and G to add it to a group. Now our layer is inside a group, and I'll apply the pattern overlay to the group itself. Just double-click the group to open its layer style. Click on the pattern overlay. As you can see, the pattern is now applied to the visible pixels only. Let's import our tutorial's patterns. From this little icon, choose Import Patterns. You can download them for free from the description below. You will get 4 sketch patterns like this. Just select the first one and change opacity to 100%. Keep angle 0 and change scale to 80. Change blend mode to multiply, then click OK. Decrease the fill to 0 to hide the main layer and keep the pattern visible. With the group selected, press Ctrl and J to duplicate it. Double-click the duplicated group to open its layer style. Change the pattern to Sketch 2. And set the angle to 15%. Then click OK. With your top group selected, press Ctrl and J to duplicate it again. Double-click the duplicated group to change its pattern like the previous one. Choose the Sketch 3 pattern. And also change the scale to 18%. Then click OK. But this time, open the top group and double-click the layer itself. Under the blending options, go to the Blend If and change its value to 120 and 220. This will target other areas and apply this pattern to them. Click OK and duplicate the top group again for the last time. Double-click that duplicated group and finally, change the pattern to Sketch 4. Set scale to 35% and click OK. As you can see, this is the final result for now. And that's why we used the Multiply Blend mode to blend all groups together. Now select the bottom layer and create a white solid color above it. And that's why we used the Blend If to target different areas with keeping the highlight areas untouched. And for the bright areas, you will find that slight sketching effect, and vice versa regarding the dark areas. Now select the four groups by holding the Shift key. Then press Ctrl and G to group them. Name the group as you want, and let's move to the next step. Step 2. Add the details. Now select the bottom layer and make it visible. Duplicate it twice using Ctrl and J. Rename them Dark Details and Overall Details. Select them using the Ctrl key and drag and drop them to the top like that. Hide the Overall Details layer and select the Main Details one. Now go to Filters, Blur, and choose Gaussian Blur. Change Radius to 5 and click OK. Change the Blend Mode to Overlay and decrease the opacity to 20%. Select the Overall Details layer and unhide it. Go to Filter and choose Filter Gallery. Under the Artistic folder, select the Smudge Stick filter. Change it to 1, 20, and 10, then click OK. Change the Blend Mode to Overlay with 20% opacity. Now with your layer selected, go and create a new layer. After that, pick the Brush tool and let's import the tutorial brushes. From this little icon, click Import Brushes. You can download these brushes for free from the description below. Select the Stroke 1 brush, then change both opacity and flow to 100. And with your layer selected, start painting over it like that. Select the Overlay 1 brush and start painting with some random lines like that. Finally, you can add some small particles using the Particles 1 brush. Now select the three layers and press Ctrl and G to group them. Name the group Details. And with the group selected, go and create a Hue and Saturation layer. Decrease the saturation all the way down to 0. Finally, let's create a Levels layer. Increase the Shadow slider to 40. Now let's see the before and after. That's great! Let's move to the final step. Step 3. Testing. First, please save your final result as a PSD file for any future use. Make sure it is a PSD file, then click Save. Now let's reapply the effect on a new image. Just double-click on the Smart Object thumbnail to open it. Once you're inside the Smart Object, go to File, Place Embedded to import your image. Place the image and resize it as you want. Press Ctrl and S to save it. Get back to your main document, and that's it! You can control the details by increasing or decreasing the opacity of those two layers. Also, you can hide this Hue and Saturation layer to get a colorful sketch effect like that. Let's test it on another image. Import the image inside the Smart Object. Resize the image and press Ctrl and S. Get back to your document. That's it for today. Please like the video and subscribe for more free tutorials. Thanks for watching.